So I want to talk to you guys about how you can make money with your content right now without having like a huge following, a bunch of likes on Instagram and subscribers on YouTube, because there's huge potential for you guys to still be earning from content creation. Today's video is sponsored by Wirestock. They are an online stock media licensing website that allows you to distribute your stock footage to all of the main stock licensing sites, all within that one website. I'm going to talk to you guys about them a little bit later on in this video. I want to start off by saying, even if you guys don't currently have a following, I personally believe that it's a good idea to start trying to build that up, even if it's not going to be the money-making source that we are after in this video. At least you can start putting things out onto the internet, even if you don't want to have that as your end goal, like to make money from something like YouTube. I think it's still hugely beneficial to build that up. It's going to give you more credibility having all of your content online. It's going to give you a place to direct potential clients to go and check out your work and your latest projects. I think there's a huge benefit of putting all your work out online. So in my opinion, step one before we actually even start making money without any followers is to start putting your content out so that you can start generating followers. When I first started out with this whole thing, I knew that the end goal for me was to build a YouTube channel just like this one and an Instagram account. And what I did was use these different techniques that we're going to talk about in today's video to give myself the free time and the financial ability, and then I could focus all of my time into creating YouTube videos and Instagram content for my own platforms to build this up slowly over time. Originally, I wanted to create a lot of like travel style content, which is still what I'm doing now, but I needed a way to be able to generate income while I was traveling so that I could shoot those travel videos for myself. One of the first things that I came up with and a way to achieve this was to shoot videos for brands. Now you have to keep in mind, even if you guys don't have a following, there is a huge value that you can offer any of these brands or companies because they themselves need content to build up their own following on any of their social media platforms. So whether that's for a clothing company, a sunglass company, a jewelry company, any sort of items that people are selling, you can get in contact with these people and create content for them. So this was one of my main revenue streams when I was traveling and actually generating income from outside stuff other than YouTube. And this allowed me to generate that income relatively easy because I just needed to carry around a couple of different things with me while I was traveling, like some clothing or sunglasses, and I could shoot different videos of those things and then give that content to those companies and they would pay me in return. The other thing that I started to do is to reach out to actual establishments. So while you guys are traveling, I'm sure there's gonna be a bunch of places that you'll see, whether that's hotels or cafes and restaurants, maybe it's beach clubs, and you can shoot content for all of these people while you're moving around into these different cities and countries around the world, and that is also gonna give you more income to allow you to keep creating your own videos. One of the most important things to think about is that you have a huge value to offer to all of these brands. It's not only a following that they can benefit from. So shooting this content for them allows them to build up their own following, and that's exactly what we can offer and get paid in return for. The only thing important to remember with this is there might be some certain visa requirements to actually work in different countries. So make sure you check it out for the place you are thinking of going in particular, but you should be pretty good, and this is a fantastic way. Fantastic is a very fantastic word. This is a fantastic way for you guys to actually generate some income while moving around and creating content. Something that goes quite well with this is shooting content for any sort of travel companies, whether it's companies offering some sort of excursions or it's actual travel agencies that offer different bookings in different countries. You can also try and reach out to the tourism board of countries in particular and create content for them. This is a really awesome one because essentially you're just going to be capturing all of the awesome moments in that country, which you guys can reuse all that footage for your own content to go on your YouTube channel and stuff. That's something that I really focused on. A lot of the content that I could shoot for brands, day clubs, travel agencies or anything like that, I could repurpose and use for my own YouTube channel and generate videos. So it was kind of like two birds with one stone. Another way that you can reuse any of this footage that you're actually shooting for other companies, once you've been paid by them to do it, you still have the rights to use that footage and you can upload it onto a stock website and actually generate passive income from that. And that brings me to the sponsor of today's video, which is Wirestock. One of the hardest things when you guys are doing stock footage is that you wanna try and upload it to all of the major stock sites so that you have a higher chance of actually selling that footage. Wirestock allows you to upload footage and stock images all to one place and they distribute it to all of the main stock media selling sites and you don't have to worry about any of them. This also means that you have one dashboard where you can track your analytics and see where you're selling it and how many of your products you are selling all within that one place on Wirestock. They have some really cool features. They offer free keywording and tagging for all of your videos, which is another like huge time eating like thing to try and do that for each one of your clips. And they also don't charge any fees to use their service. They only take a small commission when you actually sell some of your footage. So they only make money when you as the creator makes money. If you guys wanna check out Wirestock, this is an awesome way to generate some income and give a lot of your footage a second life. You can check them out in the top of the description. They are completely free to sign up with and you guys can start making money like this. The next thing that I recommend is actually shooting content for other creators or influencers that do have a following. And this is becoming more and more elusive as more creators actually build up their following and it becomes a more common thing to find in the world. So you can reach out to creators, maybe it's a model and she's on vacation in the same place that you're in. You can shoot like a photo shoot for her on the beach and you can sell those photos to her or she will pay you for doing that photo shoot. And then that also gives you some awesome work that you can put in your portfolio and keep showing to potential other people. Maybe there is a YouTuber in the place that you're at and they want some travel video style stuff of them in this country. You can go and shoot that for them. They might be on their own and not have a videographer with them. They can hire you out as a freelance videographer and you can shoot the content for them in that particular area. This is also great because you're gonna be making connections with other creators and as you start building up your audience and your following like we suggested doing in the beginning of this video, you are also getting a little bit of a network of other creators that maybe you can work with in the future or reach out to in some other regard later down the line. So this is hugely beneficial. It's super fun, super easy, and there's kind of an infinite amount of creators that you guys can reach out to. The last thing that I wanted to talk to you about, and this does work slightly better once you guys do generate a bit of a following, but hopefully by now you've kind of got a couple of followers on Instagram, maybe a couple of subscribers on YouTube, and what you can do then is you can come up with some sort of product, a digital asset, maybe it's prints for some of your best photos you've taken on your travels, or maybe it's something like Lightroom presets or LUTs for videos. You could even come up with something like merch and sell some sort of clothing to some of your subscribers and followers. You'll be surprised how few followers you actually need to still sell a couple of items. And there's a really cool saying that it's 1,000 true fans will make an artist successful. And the way that if you launch something and you could get 1,000 people to buy it, you could keep launching new products and everything. And if those core 1,000 people were to keep buying your products, you would be completely fine as an artist. So that's an important thing to remember. It's easy to see like huge numbers of creators on the internet with like millions of followers. You don't necessarily need that many to actually generate a stable income. I know some people that have like 10 to 20,000 subscribers on YouTube and they're making a huge amount of money because of how they've monetized their channel and how they've released their own digital assets and things like we mentioned in this. So keep that in mind, build up that following slowly as you go, keep doing the other work, and I'm sure you guys will have enough free time and monetary support to keep pursuing your dream of content creation. I hope you guys thought this video was useful. Remember to check out Wirestock. They are gonna be linked down in the description. It's an amazing way to make passive income. You do the work once, and then you never have to worry about it again. Other than that, I will see you in the next one. Bye.